my wife Jennifer died 7 months ago in a kind of difficult circumstances from a ruptured colon and a toxemia and a sepsis of the abdomen. She was 42 years old and the mother of a three-year-old girl, Bella. And I lost my soulmate, mother of my child, my best friend, the kind of thing that made me feel safe in the world, and the person that made everything okay.
I am fortunate that I ever met Ray, because he was so special. There's really no one else like him.
We're here today for my husband and their father, Lloyd Ingber, and passed away about 6 months ago from cancer.
My boyfriend's name was Job, and he was killed in a motorcycle accident in July of 2004. He was killed instantly, so he didn't suffer, we know that.
My husband, Jack, died on July 1st in a motorcycle accident, and it's been 8 months of hell on earth for me. And he told all of the family that he visited in Minnesota on his way to his mom's in Wisconsin that he had the best life. And he did. We did.
My wife was Kamala, and on January 5th of 2004, we just come back from a trip in Hawaii, and it was our first night home. And the next morning, which was a Sunday morning, she just didn't wake up.
I lost my boyfriend David to a heroin overdose. I used to say to him, I don't want to get that phone call saying they found you somewhere dead. And this was about the alcohol. And sure enough, I got this phone call saying they had found him dead. And sometimes we'd fight so badly, I'd just say to God, please take him out of my life. And this happened.
I lost my dad, Charlie, to cancer, like everything cancer, when he was 49 and I was 22. He was the number one person in my life. He just knew me, and it makes me upset he won't be able to see me become that.
I don't think I'll ever fully heal. I think I'll learn to function with such a big, you know, scar.
What do you miss most about your mother?
Her smile.
How would that make you feel when she smiled?
Just like filled the room with happiness.
Tell me your story.
My name is Brian Schaefer. I was born in Wisconsin. Went to school down in Tucson where I met Jennifer Ann Pritchard, and she hated when obituaries would always describe cancer patients as having battled cancer. She used to say, I'm not at war, you know, I don't even know who I'm fighting. I don't even know what color their uniforms are. I'm not a soldier. I'm just trying to get out of bed in the morning. She passed away on her birthday, her 42nd birthday. And the morning of her birthday, for the first time I was able to tell her just in her ear, not to mention that I love her, but it's okay to go.
You say you wonder, you're beautiful love. 'Cause everybody's changed.